Hi guys, my name is Megan. Welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about how I'm preparing for postpartum. Now, this might be kind of a long video because pregnancy, a birth, and that magical postpartum period where you're with your baby for the very first few weeks and is learning how to be a family with another addition is just something I'm so passionate about, and I'm just like obsessed with researching about this. And so I have so much stuff to share with you guys and so much stuff I'm getting ready because I'm just so excited about this. So I hope this is helpful for you guys and you enjoy this video, and let's get right into this list. So now, just a warning before we get started, this video is going to be very TMI because we're talking about postpartum, like we've just had a baby and started breastfeeding and all of these different things. So there's going to be things in this video that are a little bit TMI. And so if that's not something that you want to hear, I totally understand if you don't want to watch this, but I just wanted to give this little warning so that I didn't like take you by surprise too much. So the first thing I wanted to talk about is the importance of resting. Your body has just gone through a huge ordeal. You've carried and grown this baby through 9 months of pregnancy, and your ligaments have stretched and your skin is stretched, and then you've birthed this baby and you might have torn, you might have had a C-section. There's just so much that has happened to your body in such a short period of time. And I think in our culture, we are just too apt to want to bounce back, and women don't give their bodies enough time to heal, and they are too hard on themselves because on the inside of your uterus where your placenta was is a huge wound. And I think just because we can't see that wound, we don't realize how important it is for us to rest. It's more important for your body to heal properly so that you don't have problems later on than it is to bounce back and get your pre-pregnancy body. We don't want to cause damage to our bodies that can like cause issues later on with future pregnancies. Maybe not be able to have as many pregnancies or natural births because we didn't let our bodies heal properly. And so, especially because I know I want to have a lot of kids and a lot of pregnancies and be able to birth them all at home naturally, I'm really doing everything I can now to make sure that when I do have my baby, I can like take as much time as I need to rest, like 7 to 14 days of resting and trying to stay in bed, maybe going from the bed to the couch, but just not walking upstairs, at least for the first week, and just taking that time to bond with the baby and get breastfeeding established and letting my body heal. So one important tip is to lower your expectations. The house is going to probably be really messy for a while, but you just gotta realize that this is a really short time, a really important time where you just need to focus on yourself and your baby, and everything else can just kind of fall by the wayside for a while. So just lower your expectations of what you're gonna get done, what your family's gonna get done, like how your kids are gonna act. Just lower your expectations of everything. The next thing is ask people for help. It's a great idea to, now while you're still pregnant, to line people up to help bring meals and clean and maybe watch your other kids for a while. People want to help, and I know it is really hard for me to let people help, and I was kind of not very good at this with my daughter. I mean, I let people bring meals, but I didn't let anyone come clean, and I really wish I had, because people really want to help and they don't mind coming to help. And I know it's hard to feel like you're inconveniencing people, but you're really not, and it's really great if you can do that. It's really great if your husband can take some time off of work to help you. I'm hoping that my husband can take at least a week or two off of work when the baby's born, just to help me with transitioning from 1 to 2 kids, and my daughter will only be 15 months old when I have a newborn. And so if you're at all able, I know some people are in a position where they're not able to do that. They don't have a spouse, or their husband has to work or something like that. But if you're able to do that, that's what I'm hoping that I can do. And he was able to take off a lot of work when my daughter was born, and it was just so, so helpful. That's like one of the things that got me through the postpartum period the most, was having my husband home with me. The next thing is that it's okay to set up boundaries with people and say no to people visiting. It's great if you can let people come help and bring meals, but if someone just wants to come for a visit or just see the baby and you're just so tired and you just can't handle it, it's not going to hurt their feelings to set up proper boundaries to protect yourself and your children. And because if you overdo it too much and then your cranky leader to your family, it's not really doing anyone any help. So just make sure you set up proper boundaries with people and don't feel guilty about declining visits if you're not ready for visits. The next tip is another super helpful one, is that if now, while you're pregnant, you can get freezer meals ready. Freezer meals are the best thing, and I didn't do as many of them with my daughters as I should have, and I haven't had enough time so far during this pregnancy to do them. So hopefully, as I'm getting closer to the end, I'm only like 32 weeks right now, so I have a little more time to make some freezer meals, but they are so helpful. You just pop a meal out of the freezer and put it in the oven, and it's ready, and you don't have to worry about overdoing it or walking too much, and it's amazing. You can write instructions on the freezer meal so that you can just tell your husband, just go pick a meal out of the freezer and follow the instructions that are written on it, and it's just so nice. The next thing that I've been getting ready are canned foods. And so I actually canned some chili this year, and I also canned some kidney beans. And so that's gonna be a really great meal. You can pull out a jar of chili and a jar of beans and put them in a pot together, and boom, dinner's ready. It's just gonna be so nice and easy. I also have a ton of like canned fruit, like pears and peaches and grapes, and just things that would make a really nice easy snack. It's like ready to go. You can have it over yogurt or something like that. Just have a lot of pre-prepared food that's just healthy and still just like easy to get out. Now moving more into postpartum healing. One of my favorite things that I had with my daughter, and I think this helped so much with how fast I healed, I actually tore in like 3 different places. I had a lot of stitches, and my midwife was actually really surprised with how fast I healed. And the only thing that I did different was use this homemade herbal bath. And this has plantain leaf, calendula flowers, witch hazel, lavender, and chamomile. And all those things have different like antifungal, antibacterial, anti-inflammatory properties. They help heal wounds. They help with hemorrhoids. Like all these different herbs have some amazing qualities that are just like perfect for postpartum healing. I actually just did a video with this recipe, and I talked more in detail about each of the herbs, so I will link that video for you guys below. The next thing is a peri bottle. And now this is for cleaning yourself down there after you go to the bathroom, because you're not supposed to wipe, especially if you have stitches. And even if you don't get stitches, it's been like severely stretched out after going through labor. So you don't want to wipe it with toilet paper. It's just too rough for it right now. So this was a lifesaver. If you put a little bit of warm water in this, and then you can spray yourself and then just pat it dry with the toilet paper, it feels so good. It doesn't irritate it. One great tip is to fill this with, after you make your postpartum herbal tea, put a little bit of it in this and then use that towards yourself. And so it just gives you double benefit of having a gentle cleaning and then all the great anti-inflammatory properties of that herbal tea, and it's just gonna help you heal really nicely. If you're having a hospital birth, I think they will send you home with one of these, but I'm planning on having a home birth. So I actually bought this one in a home birth supply kit when I had my daughter, and then I just washed out really good and saved it, and I'm gonna wash it out really good again before I have this baby, and I'm just gonna reuse it. The next thing that I'm getting ready are reusable period pads. And these ones are actually just regular size period pads. They're kind of small, so I know these won't work for the beginning of postpartum when you're bleeding like crazy. So actually, I'm gonna be ordering some like really big, like 14 inch size period pads for like really heavy flow, but reusable, because I am super passionate about using reusable period pads. I use cloth diapers on my children, and so I didn't use as many as I would have liked to with my daughter, and so I'm just gonna make sure I have a nice stash of cloth pads so that I can use them this time around. I do have a partial box of regular disposable pads that another mama gave me who just had a baby. She used part of this and they gave me the extra, so I'll probably use these for just the first couple days when I don't feel like washing period pads, but we'll see. I figured it'd be nice to at least have the option and have them here in case I do want them. The next thing is after ease tincture, and I actually don't have it here to show you guys because I still need to order it, but I've heard so many mamas recommend this stuff, the after ease tincture, and I will link it for you guys below if you want to check it out. But after you give birth, and especially when you breastfeed, you get really, really bad after birth pains, like contractions, and it's just your uterus shrinking back to its normal size. It's important for healing and all of that stuff, but it's not poachable, at least I've heard. I've had one birth already, but I didn't have that with my first one because generally you don't have it with your first, just generally second, and all your next births will have these after pains. So I'm a little nervous because I've heard that they do feel like labor pains sometimes and they can be pretty intense. So I'm making sure that I have some of this after ease tincture. I think you just put it under your tongue and it's an herbal tincture. It's healthy. I don't have to worry about any toxins. If that doesn't work and they're just completely too unbearable, I will talk to my midwife about maybe using Advil or ibuprofen or something like that. I'm not sure which one of those things are safe to take while you're breastfeeding. I haven't taken any Advil or ibuprofen or any pain medication since I got pregnant with my daughter Sophia, and that was a while ago. So I try to avoid those in general, but I do want to have them around just in case these are crazy, because I don't really know what to expect. I've never experienced these before. The next thing is large mesh panties. I had these with my daughter and they were amazing, and you just put your pad right in these, like, they're just super soft, stretchy, huge adult panties. They look like a diaper and they are the least sexy thing I have ever worn, but they're so comfortable, and after you've just given birth, you're not super worried about looking sexy, you just want to be comfortable. So I don't have any of these right now because I'm actually needing to order them in my home birth supply kit, and then I will get some of them that way. But those are definitely something I'm going to be ordering. The next thing on the list is prune juice or some other kind of stool softener, because the first time you go poop after having a baby is kind of terrifying and painful, and so you just want to make sure that your stool is not too firm. So after I had my daughter Sophia, I just used prune juice. It's just nice and natural and healthy and safe at the direction of my midwife, and that just helped it be soft enough that it wasn't too painful and scary. A little TMI, I know, but this is postpartum that we're talking about here. Next thing that I have ready are supplies to make castor oil packs. I actually had these ready to go when I had my daughter, and for some reason I guess I just forgot that I had them, and I just never did it, which is so disappointing because I've heard so many great things about castor oil packs for postpartum. But I've heard such great things about how this helps you heal, and so I'm going to be making some packs. This is some wool flannel, and I'll cut it into strips that are the size for my stomach. And then you just take some of the castor oil and get this all soaked with it, and you put it over your stomach, and then you put another towel over it, and then you put a hot rice bag on top of it, and the heat just really helps the benefits of the castor oil penetrate into your skin and body, and it helps you heal really nicely. So when I make those, I'm hoping to do a video on it, so I'll go into more detail about why these are so great to do, but I'm really excited to try it this time. I am not going to forget again. And then that kind of goes along with having a rice or flax bag or a heating pad, but that's for using with the castor oil pack, and then also just for if you're feeling achy, like your stomach just kind of loose and it might feel achy, you might want to put a heating pad on your lady bits if it's feeling really sore, and you know, it's just nice to have the option of a rice bag if you need it somewhere, and they're just nice and cozy, so I'm definitely gonna have one of those right on hand. The next thing is ice packs, and you can make some homemade ice packs with like corn syrup, I think, and use Ziploc bags, and then they're just nice and still flexible even when they're frozen, so I'm planning on making some of those because you might want to ice your lady bits as well. It could feel good, especially if you've had stitches. And then also, I used ice packs when I was first starting breastfeeding, and because when your milk comes in, you might get really engorged and the baby might not be able to start the milk flow. So it's really nice to just have an ice pack on hand to put on your breast so that things stick out enough for the baby to grab a hold of, if you know what I mean. I remember the night my milk came in, Sophia woke up in the middle of the night to nurse, and I tried to latch her on. We had had no previous problems with her latching or getting milk, and she couldn't latch, and I freaked out, and I called my midwife and I was like, my breasts are broken, she can't nurse, I don't know what's wrong. And she's like, just put an ice pack on it for a minute and it'll stick out enough for Sophia to grab hold of. And it worked like a charm, so I'm gonna remember that for this time and hopefully not have to call my midwife all in a panic. So So you can keep that in mind for if you're gonna be breastfeeding, you might wanna have a nice pack on hand for when your milk comes in and you're really engorged and the baby can't get it started. The next thing is comfortable, nursing-friendly clothes. And so again, when you're in your postpartum, you don't really care how you look or anything. So I love having this nursing gown. It's just this long cotton soft gown. I have two pairs of these. One's a little bit different of color, but for like the first week, I only wore that. So it's long enough that I didn't have to wear pants. You can just have your mesh panties and your pad on and not have to worry about trying to pull up and down pants, because this is long enough that you'll be modest walking around the house. Or if you have visitors come, I felt fine just wearing that. And then it also has a flap here for breastfeeding, so you can access. You don't have to try to pull it down, so that's really nice. Until my milk came in, I didn't even worry about wearing a bra. I was all about comfort. For the first few days, I wore this and my mesh panties and pad. And then once my milk came in, I did wear a bra, and that was only just so I could use a pad to catch all the milk that was leaking. And that goes right into my next thing, is I have a bunch of reusable breast pads, and I use these with my daughter, and it's just really nice because you had just invested in them once and then you just have them. And I'm, again, all for using reusable stuff. They're just a really nice, soft, comfortable material, and the back is waterproof. All these are different colors on the back. So this is a lot of breast pads, but I leaked a lot and I found this was a really good amount for me. I would go through all of these. Depending on how much you leak, you might need to have a lot on hand. And then the next thing are really comfortable bras without underwire. I haven't worn bras with underwire for like 2 years now, and I'm never going back. I just love some really stretchy, soft, comfortable sports bras. And I use these for breastfeeding because you can just pull it down, and because it's all soft and stretchy, it doesn't hurt to do that. So once my milk came in, I would wear some sort of soft, stretchy, comfortable bra like that. I do have one nursing bra that is specifically for nursing because it has a latch, but it doesn't have underwire, and I really like that one as well. But again, just find clothes that you feel really comfortable in that are really soft, because that's what you're gonna want in postpartum. Then the next thing is a little bit of coconut oil. And this is for just a really simple nipple cream, because when you're first starting breastfeeding, they can get kind of sore and dry. I actually didn't have much of a problem with it. It just got a little sore, so I would use just a little coconut oil on it. If you have a really bad problem where your nipples are starting to get cracked and bleeding, you may need to use something stronger. But if I can use coconut oil, I will, because this is safe for the baby to eat. And so I don't have to worry about washing it off when I need to breastfeed her and I put some of this on already. The next thing is decide what you're going to do with your placenta. If you're going to eat it, encapsulate it. There's a bunch of different things you can do if you're going to consume it. I am going to eat my placenta. I did with my daughter, and there's just so many amazing benefits to eating a placenta. All the protein and hormones and stuff that are important that are in your placenta are just going to waste. And so I found that it really helped with my balancing my hormones, because your hormones are just like everywhere in postpartum. So I found it really helped with that, and just more energy and all of that stuff. So I will be doing a video hopefully on how I prepare my placenta. It's just really simple. I will go into a little bit more detail about why it's good to do it and why specifically I'm doing it, but I'm planning on doing that. So just make sure you have all these like little details like decided on, so that you know like what to tell your midwife. Like, I want to say this, keep that in my refrigerator. And then my last tip is to just expect the baby blues. Like, baby blues are really common, and it's just when you have your baby, all your hormones are just crazy. Like, postpartum hormones are insane. And when I had my daughter Sophia, I had no idea that you would get the baby blues. And so they kind of took me by surprise, and I was like, what, do I have postpartum depression? Like, I thought it was something more serious. But baby blues are totally normal. Like, for the first week or more even, you might feel like really weird and sad, and like for no reason you're like, I have this amazing little baby that I've been waiting for this moment. Why do I feel sad? And it's totally normal, and just try to embrace all the emotions as much as you can. And that's one reason I really wish I would have known about this, was because I just tried to push all away, and I wish I had embraced it more, and just like, because that is part of the postpartum experience sometimes, is that you're very emotional, and if you can just embrace all the feelings that you're having and pray a lot and talk to your husband, those two things were what helped me when I was in the baby blues the most, was prayer and talking to my husband. And then also, if you're able to just step outside for a minute and breathe the fresh air, and that really helps too, if you can like do that while your baby's napping, or just wrap your baby up and just like step outside. Like, don't go for a long walk, because obviously you need to rest and heal, but just getting some fresh air and seeing the sky and not being cooped up for a super long time really helps too. But just be prepared that it's gonna be kind of a weird time and an amazing time, and now me going into it for the second time, I kind of know what to expect, and I know exactly what I need to prepare for this and get ready, and so I'm just looking forward to a lot more. I'm not as nervous and scared of it, and so hopefully I'll just be able to embrace all the emotions and change and everything. So hopefully some of these things were helpful for you guys, maybe gave you some ideas for things that you should be getting ready if you're pregnant, or things that you could help a new mom with, like if you know someone who's pregnant and is about to give birth, some of these things might be a great gift for her. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!